Ladies and gentlemen, welcome and get ready for a show of a lifetime. Here he is, your one and only entertainer, straight from the Netherlands, Mr. Paul the Bakker.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. First of all, isn't she cute? Aww. Yeah, that's what I thought. So I was walking on the street the other day when I came across this cell that is about to undergo mitosis. It says to me, "I hope I have your divided attention." That's something, right? Yeah. So by the way, do you know how you can tell the difference between a male chromosome and a female chromosome? You take down their genes. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So basically what I'm saying is, I'm not so sure where... What? What is that sound? What is that? Oh no, I'm dreaming! What time is it? Oh, 1:30 a.m. Woken by my little nightingale. Don't worry, honey. I'll go and tuck her in again. Hey there, honey. Lucas here. It's Daddy. Oh, come on. Daddy's here to cheer you up. Pippa, sweetie. Do you want me to play you a nice tune? Or tell you a bedtime story? Here we go. How about some nice and sweet cosmogenesis story? Okay. You want something more difficult than perhaps chaos theory? Ha! I know what you want. You want the greatest bedtime story ever. Here we go. This is also Daddy's favorite. It's time to tell you the story of my life. A long, long time ago, in this cute little country called the Netherlands, a little boy was born named Paul. Paul the Bakker. Now, soon after he was born, it became quite clear for the people around him that little Paul was just not just handsome, but also an extremely smart boy with a determined mind to investigate. Everybody loved Paul. Even Paul loved Paul, actually. And on school, as long as his teachers could remember little Paul, he would ask question after question after question.
Alright kids, welcome to your first day of primary school. My name's Mr. Brown. Today I'll teach you some basic calculus. So I want you to imagine that I have one apple, and you, Paul, have one pear. So how many pieces of fruit do Paul and I have in total?
Two, Mr. Brown!
Well, that depends.
I'm sorry, Paul.
What if I cut my pear into pieces? Then one fruit would be multiple pieces, right?
Yes, Paul, you're right. That could have made a difference.
Huh, so be more precise the next time.
Alright kids, so I'm sure you know all this. What kind of corner do we see right here?
Perpendicular, Mr. Garrison.
Yes, very good. Everybody understands. So in the next corner, hold on there. What's wrong, Paul? Well, you're assuming just two dimensions under this model, but there could easily be a third dimension with another angle. So this is highly confusing. Well, Paul, I guess you're right. That could have made a difference. You have to be more precise with these things. Why, thank you, Paul. Good advice.
And so we can see that it's not the matter itself that decides how toxic it is, but it's rather the dose.
Stop right there, Professor! Are you so foolish to think that—
Paul, knock it off with the Darth Vader mask.
Sorry.
So, after my, well, impressive educational career, it was time for a new challenge. I came across this hat from Harvard, and I immediately felt I should respond. Daddy got hired there. And instantly felt at home.
Thank you for your attention. Are there any questions about my presentation?
So, basically, what you're saying is that you find a 99% concordance with SNP-chip data, but what about the triallelic SNPs?
That's a very good point, thanks. By the way, take a look at our new lab toy.
That is so awesome.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your attention. I'm highly confident about these results. Are there any questions?
Well, I'm not so sure about what you presented. This approach requires a non-centrality parameter of the lambda value. And did you realize that genes—
She may be the face I can't forget, a trace of pleasure or regret, maybe my treasure or the price I have to pay. She may be the song the summer sings, maybe the chill the—
Marieke, you know that there's a big attraction between us, and we are really connected, so I guess basically what I'm trying to say is we should collaborate more.
What do you mean, Paul?
Well, I was thinking of doing our own genetic experiment. Our own private genetic experiment.
Oh, Paul! I thought you'd never ask! You're so romantic! But where to conduct this experiment? I'm starting my specialization soon in the Netherlands.
Well, it just so happens to be that I'm invited to work at pretty much every university there.
So, the Netherlands it is.
And so it happened. I visited every university that offered me a job. The first place was at the Erasmus Medical Center, located on a ship in the Rotterdam Harbor. But the moment I entered, your daddy got seasick. That didn't work. Next was the Amsterdam Medical Center. I guess I just wasn't ready for that. So then I tried to go to Groningen. But of course, that was too far, so I never arrived. Then, finally, I went to Utrecht. I found what I was looking for. A warm welcome. And of course, it's the best university ever. The end. So, there it is, the story of my life. I bet you loved that story, didn't you? Oh, okay. Well, time to put you to bed then. Good night, sweetie. Daddy loves you.
Greetings, young Padawan. Noble genetics professor, you have become, almost, dangerous the path to professorship is. One final task to complete you must. Darth Vader is luring at you as we speak, and confronted with him you will be. Good luck, young Pearl.
Young Paul, it is time to face your adversary. Fight me.
Ha